Hey guys, Zul'jin here, and welcome to Star Wars Galaxies. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. I'm back on SWGEmu, and we're on the Basilisk server, and I'm having a good old time. I did a live stream yesterday and got a ton of scouting experience with my cousin and good friend, Ronnie, and now I am a little bit into creature handling. I thought I would show you a little bit how this skill works. So there's a few ways that you can get creature handler experience, but in order to do that, look at me all contemplating. In order to do that, the first thing you have to do is do kind of what I talked to you about last video, and that's get enough scout experience on this first and third row in order to get to creature handler. And then you have to get a lot of scout experience to actually get the minimum Novus creature handler ability, and then you can start moving into here and getting creature handler experience. So I've got that, and the Novus creature handler ability gives you the chance to have pets out. It gives you a max pet level of 12. Stored pets is 4, so you could store up to 4 pets at a time, and taming wild creatures, and that's basically what you do. You also have a few commands that you can teach them, and you can tame them, which is the most important part. So to get creature handling experience, there's two things you can do. Well, three things, actually. You can tame wild creatures, naturally. You can also, which can only be in a baby form. So see these Corellian butterflies over here? You can't tame those because they're full grown. It has to say baby, just like that one. And they're always weaker than their counterparts. So I'm not using a weapon right now because every once in a while they get mad when you try to tame them. And if they attack, you counterattack and you'll smoke them like in one shot. So we're not trying to do that. To get creature handling experience, you can also teach them commands. And you can also attack with them. They only have to do damage and to any mobs. It can be more than once or only once, as long as the creature does damage to it before it dies, and it does happen to die, then you get creature handling experience, and it's all based on the proximity of what level they are to whatever they are fighting. So, and it's kind of capped, so there's some diminishing returns, but for the most part, let's just start by taming. So I went ahead and used my Mass Scent. Mass Scent doesn't really help against these guys as much, but when you go into the vicious creatures, like the ones that red attack on sight, mask scent is essential. So anyway, let's try to tame this baby, shall we? It's only a little Corellian butterfly, but we'll try it. Sometimes it takes a good little while. I've also got a couple of other pets. I started out on Naboo, and I'm on Corellia right now. One of the reasons is Naboo, the beginning stuff available for pets, the creatures at low levels, they're kind of weak sauce. Kind of like the Corellian butterfly is probably going to be. But we'll see here. Let's see if I can tame it on first try. Come on, baby. Nope, I failed. Okay, the good thing is once you start taming, they kind of stay still, so that's pretty good. You can do some other things. I've been playing around with this. This is a little macro for crafting, and in order to make it work, you just have to double-click the three different components once it prompts you, and it takes about 5 seconds to run the macro, and you start crafting, and I've been crafting some traps in my spare time so that I can raise my, my survival skill. Instead of crafting camps. Now, when I do get my next one, I killed it with my bare hands. Dang it! See what I mean? It got mad. Oh well. It could be worse. So anyway, and that's, I'm glad I took my weapon out. It would have been a lot more brutal with the laser rifle. But anyway, so in order to get camping experience, you either need to camp, have people sit in your camp, or craft camps or items that give you survival experience, and that's what I'm trying to do now because I want to go into Master Scout. Master Scout, I need a little bit more survival experience, actually quite a bit more survival experience to get to Master Scout, and once you get at Master Scout, you can actually see a portion of what's going on with a creature's level. So take these for instance. Let me go ahead and examine. And I don't know what level it is. I know statistically it's more powerful than me because of the red look on it. But you can see here its stats. But you don't know anything about how much hit points it has and all this other stuff. And as you climb through the scout. Well, once you get Master Scout, it'll show you what the creature level is. And also, when you get any skills in Ranger, which I might get a little bit of, it gives you more information. And this character is mainly, I know creature handlers aren't the most powerful the most powerful characters in the world and stuff, but I want to do it because it's a great way to explore the game, and it's a lot of fun just messing around with that. What is that? Disciples of Lord Nyx? I don't think I want to mess with that at all. I need to find a, let me go ahead and get my my speeder bike out here. Nope, that's not what I wanted to do. There we go. While I'm waiting for my speeder bike, I might as well craft up something, get a little bit of experience. I'm using practice mode because it's a little bit easier. If you're curious about the macro I'm using, I suppose I should show you that. People are gonna be like, show us the macro, Z. I'm sorry. Okay, so this is the, not AFK shooting, craft trap is what I have. And that's it right there. I'm gonna go edit macro so you guys can see. But this is it. You have to retype that in anyway, so you could pause the video and copy it from there. But that's the macro right there, and it does a pretty good job. You can take the little practice no item out of both of those lines if you actually want to craft the item. But I'm using practice. The reason I'm using practice is it actually it gives you more experience when you practice, and it doesn't clutter your inventory with items. Okay, so these are plumed rasped, and there is a baby. So I'm gonna try to tame that baby. I'm gonna try to tame the baby. Let me use mass scent. And let's start taming. This is a plumed rasp. It's a little bird. So hopefully I don't kill this. Hopefully I don't. Being that I insta-killed the other one, as soon as it got mad at me, it would kind of suck. I also have another creature that I tamed early, and I'll show you guys that in a moment. But right now, a pretty good creature too. I was surprised that I can get something that good at the beginning stages like this. It's really, really difficult to get started with creature handling. It really is. It's a ton of work, but it's fun work. For me it is, at least. So some of you are gonna be like, man, this seems incredibly tedious, and it is. I haven't really played a game outside of Ark that taming anything was easy, or getting good at taming anything was easy. Not that taming anything really hard in Ark is easy as well, but anyway, this is a fun kind of taming for me. This kind of reminds me of the Ultima Online style taming, where you had to follow creatures around and actively try to tame them and push your skill limits in order to get better at taming. So you had to tame harder and harder and harder creatures, and you would get more experienced as you went, which allowed you to tame harder and harder and harder creatures. And it was at small points at a time. So, all right, let's see. Come on, baby. You know you want to tame. Let's progress the video, shall we? Oh my gosh, failed to tame again. Oh man, well, I would pull out the other one to show you guys right now, but it's a little bit, you can't really do that all at one time, unfortunately. You can craft, however. So I don't know if you could see, but it says 30, 25, so it's ticking down on my little crafting menu. And you can use multiple crafting tools to speed this up. I just don't want to sit there and do manual crafting. I'd rather just kind of play the game and do it, you know? Let's see. One more try, man. Come on, plumed rasp. So it gets a lot easier. There's a lot of foods that you can get that will increase your taming and naturally raising levels and stuff like that. It gets a little bit easier. But taming is actually not the fastest way to get experience. The fastest way to get experience is killing other creatures with your tamed animals. And you would think, Z, this plume rasp doesn't look like it could do much. You have never been more correct, viewer. they're bad. There we go, we tamed it, yes. You have never been more correct. It is incredibly, incredibly hard to get anything done with one of these little guys, but I'll show you basically how the commands work. So we have a plumed rasp baby, and we need to teach it commands. So how do we do this? Well, basically we hit train, and then we'll say follow. Okay, So it gives a little question mark comes up, and I'm going to type follow. All right, so I taught my pet a new command. That doesn't always happen, but it does happen sometimes. So sometimes you have it gives it a it takes a couple tries. Okay, let's go ahead and train attack. Question mark, kill. Pet doesn't understand you. See, just like that. So I'm gonna try to train it again. Oops. Alright, I taught it the command. I opened up all kind of crap just in accidentally. Okay, so now that it's trained in those two, I want to show y'all something else. I have a few macros set up that are tell pet commands, and basically they are tell pet slash tell pet space kill slash tell pet space talk. Follow and slash tell pet space hide. And hide is what I use to train. So I'm gonna to train store. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this. And hide is macro to shift 3. Okay, the parent doesn't understand me. Let me try that again. Store. Okay, I learned it. So now if I type hide, it just puts it away, and it gets stored into the data pad. So you can also name your pets. You can give them 4 commands with a name in front of them. So if the pet's name was Cutie, okay, I could put Cutie Hide, and then Cutie Follow, and then Cutie Kill, and Cutie, and one more command, and basically it would learn that Cutie is its name, which is a really, really cool way of doing things. Anyway, there's a few plume rats around, and it's going to be kind of hard to show you on this. So let me just bring out my other guy here, and I'll show y'all what it is. First, let's open the data pad, and you can see that I have a few different creatures in here. I have a flute. This is, I guess that's how you say the name of it. The flute was from Naboo. Its health, action, and mind are both 42. And to give you perspective into that, I shouldn't have crouched here. To give you perspective into that, my skills, because they're buffed in the 2000s, close to 3000 some of them, but seriously, most of them are like between 500, between 700 and 1000. So that's a big difference in stats. Anyway, let's open the data pad again, and I'll show you the one that I just got. So the plumed baby, health, action, and mind are 21. In retrospect, that's half as weak as the flute, which is terrible. It shows how much damage they can do. So this one does 7 to 15, while these do 11 to 22. And it shows which commands they have along with their resistances and stuff like that. And those become very, very important depending on what you're fighting a little later on. And this is my little baby here. This is, I want to say this, Dalirake. So the Dalirake is like a little mantis or a spider. It does 8 to 17, but look at the stats, 83s. So this is a good starting pet. We're going to go ahead and call this pet. Takes 15 seconds, just like the speeder bike. Perfect time to make a little bit of trap and get some wilderness experience. And my little buddy should be coming out in just a matter of time. There it is. So babies do grow up into full-grown versions of their tames, but it takes a few days, like in real-life days, not in-game days. They grow whether they're stored or whether they're out, and whether you feed them or not. But I think feeding them may increase their growth rate. I'm not really sure. I haven't really tried. I do have a feed command, and I did feed it. It says yummy. I don't know what I fed it, but I have a feeling that I did not want to feed it that. Let's see if it says, I don't think it says what's going on, what I fed it, but anyway, I'll show you how it looks with the plume rasp. So these guys are relatively hard for me. Well, they're red, so I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and start attacking it, okay? I'm trying to kill it now. Let me put my my weapon in. You saw me? You saw me do? Alright, so now I'm going to tell it to attack. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Alright, so you can see the question marks come up. Let's try that again, but this time we're going to do it on this guy right here. Okay, Plumed Rasp. We're going to go ahead and... Actually, you know what? I think I am going to take my weapon off for now. Or should I put my other... I think I'm going to put my other one. This is my weak carbine. This is my super weak carbine. Okay. So I'm sticking my pet on it. And you see, it did hit it. I know it was hard to see, but it says you receive 50 points of creature handling experience. So that is the easiest way to get that. Just because I'm moving slow doesn't mean it is slow. Like, when you get to a nest full of stuff, it's really, really... And I'm going to just store this guy. When you get to a nest of stuff, it's really, really goes a lot faster. Or when you're killing things that you have a little bit of meat to them, you can kind of go over and over and over again and let them... Basically, you draw the attack, and then you, as when they're about to die or whatever, you just tell your pet to attack. Your pet just hits them one or two times, and then once they fall, you get the experience from them. And naturally, the gaps between creature levels start closing after a little while, and you get more and more and more. I've been looking for a baby one of these. These look pretty cool. I have no idea how hard they are to tame, you know, because I don't know creature levels yet, which is why I really, really want Master Scout. But it does do a pretty good service to find... Ooh, what are these? I haven't seen these. Wargondas? They look strong. And there's no babies. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that I couldn't even tame them. But when I do see a baby, and I don't know if it's something that I can tame, I just use Mass Scent and go up to it. And if you try to use the radio menu and tame on it, it'll tell you that you can't. Like, you lack the required skill to do it, pretty much. But other than that, creature handling is a pretty long grind. So most of my videos that aren't informative about methodology like this are probably going to be streams, as you probably saw either yesterday or today if you're keeping up with the Star Wars Galaxies content. And I'm hoping that I can do more of those because I really, really enjoy it. We have a few people that are some of my supporters, some of my Patreon subs, as well as Twitch subscribers have expressed interest in playing as well. And my cousin's been playing with me. If you saw the stream, you heard him. He doesn't do YouTube or Twitch or anything, but he does really love the game. And he's who I kind of started playing with the first time. Like, when I played Star Wars Galaxies, he was my partner in crime. Did a whole lot. Ron is an awesome guy. Anyway, we both share a very, very deep love for the game, so we'll definitely continue to play for quite a bit. I'm hoping that the content doesn't get too far out of whack, because it's really, really hard for me to get away from it lately. Probably the worst things that you can do as a YouTuber is get addicted to a game and do something for more fun than work. But my hope is that you guys like it enough for me to kind of keep producing content on it and stuff. And it would be lovely if I found something else, something to at least attack stuff with and show you how it works, or some other cool tames. I guess we'll look around a little bit, and if I find something neat, I'll bring you guys back in. Alright guys, so I've been traveling around quite a little bit, and I've found a few things that I would like to show you. These wooded paralopes, I don't know if this is something I can tame, but I imagine so, based on the con. I did die messing around with some wild stuff, but I don't have any buffs no more, and I do have quite a bit of wounds, but to show you this, I should still be able to pull it off alright. But you can see here, these wooded paralopes are kind of like some goat creatures. I don't know if you can ride these when they're full grown, but I think that it would be pretty cool. I did forget to mention that you can have mounts in the game, so there's all sorts of things you can ride, and I would love to do that instead of riding around the speeder the whole time, because that's one of the cool things about being a creature handler, is getting a mount. Anyway, I want to show you how to flush a nest. So there is a... I'm sorry it's still nighttime too, I was hoping that it would turn day sooner or later, but so all of these paralopes that are out here, there's none that are babies. And a lot of the times you can get babies to come out by attacking the nest and kind of like taking out the waves of enemies that respawn. So let's go ahead and kill these. I should just be able to one-shot them all, honestly. Not shoot the thicket, not yet. All right, now everything has perished. So let me go ahead and shoot this a couple times and make it respawn. Kind of like the way we do missions. Alright, so I stopped. I pressed peace right after that. Now let's see. Is there any babies? There wooden parallel. No, not yet. What was that over there? That is a crabu. I think I have one of those actually. Alright, let's go ahead and kill this guy. Or girl. And we're gonna try one more time to flush the nest. Oh crap, I didn't even notice. They do quite a bit of damage, man. It's not that help that I have all these fucking wounds either. Okay. Let's see. A little bit of action. Regain that. I should be able to kill this in one shot. There we go. Alright. This guy, I might have to sit down a little bit. Sit down a spell. So I'll show you guys while I'm there. By the way, I got enough skill to get the next level of survival. I just need to train that. I just got this guy a little earlier. It was a pretty uneventful tame. But he's actually stronger than the Dalirake. It's like a little goat. What's his a Cradu? Yeah, I could show you a full size one, but let me get this going first. Alright. Let's get back up. Kill this guy. Alright. So we should be able to flush the nest now. Oh. I didn't see something here. Dang it! I missed one. So what happens when you get incapped three times in a certain amount of time, things can get pretty bad. Basically, you'll have to clone. So we don't want to do that. We don't want to do that. I'll tell you what. Let me use my stim pack. There we go. That healed a little bit. Alright. And I think there's still one more, huh? No. No more. Okay. Not yet, at least. So I just gotta shoot this a few times. And it should spawn. Technically, it's usually about halfway there. I gotta watch my action board too. Come on. Okay, they just spawned. So, parallel. Baby, see that? I flushed him out. All right, so now we can try to tame this guy. Hopefully it works. Yeah, and he might be something rideable. The Cradu actually that I got earlier might be as well. Let me go ahead and put away my weapon. So if he does turn on me here, it's gonna be kind of bad. I'm gonna try to go ahead and heal myself just a little bit. I'm gonna have to go back to town and heal my wounds and stuff like that. I think I'm gonna get off Coronet and go back to Naboo to run missions and stuff, and mainly to train with my guys because I know the area a lot more. Come back here. I know the area a lot more and it's a little bit easier for me to navigate. I know who's there, I know where to get all my buffs, and I kind of know a little bit about the creatures since I've been there for a little while. So I think all in all is going to benefit me more hanging out there, just to do the majority of my creature handling. Well, at first, my creature handling. The great thing is every time I get a little bit more skill in creature handling, I open up the possibilities of getting all kind of new pets. Because it's all based on creature level and stuff, and I'll be able to store some more. So let's quickly, I'll quickly show you what I mean. I always forget the thing for... oh yeah, never mind. I found it now. So a creature handler. I think it's this one that I need. Pet command group, and max level of pets goes up by 2. So group will give me the fourth command. So I'll actually be able to name my pets, and get a little bit more experience when I do a tame as well. There's some other pets, and guard actually makes it a little bit easier to fight because when or group. I think they get experience all the time when they're in your group. Or you get a creature handling experience all the time. I'm not too sure how it works yet. But I do want to check it out. I might read up a little bit on it. Let's check it out on the other skills as well. So this one, oh, I tamed it, cool. Let's see, creature handler. This one gives me pet command stay, which is not as crucial, I don't think. The same number of pet levels, the same number of stored pets. So it's 2, 2, and 5 on all of these. Actually, this is only 2 and 5 with no basic. So I'm probably not going to learn creature taming, basic domestication until I learn these. Because, oh wait. Actually, they're all 2 plus 5 except for this one. This one gives stored pets and the stay command. This one only gives max level of pets and taming wild creatures. But pet command group. Pet command, follow, friend, train, mount. Oh, is that... Oh, you can't mount until much later? Is that how it is? Trick, enrage, guard. That's what we want. So I tell you what. I think we are going to go with this one next. The animal rapport. So let's change this instead of empathy and comprehension to rapport. So I can... So I can actually track it and know what I'm gonna do. All right, let's train this guy, shall we? Let's see, train, follow me. And that is gonna be this one. Doesn't understand me, train, follow me. There we go, train, attack. And train, store. One more time. There we go. Now we can store him and check him out. So he is 42. He's actually pretty weak, man. He's down there with the flute. So far, this is my these are my pride and joys right here. This Krabu and the Dalirake. I'll show you guys the Krabu. Takes about 15 seconds. Perfect time to craft another craft another deal here. Pull out my speeder bike as well. And there is the Krabu baby. It's like a mix between a horse and a goat. It's actually pretty neat. Oh man, it's gonna be fun messing with him. So I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, give me some dap on that like button and show your support. And you can subscribe to the channel for more daily videos. Thanks so much for watching, guys. As always, this is SWGEmu signing off. And we'll see you next time.